So this is the Super Bus. You can't really see much of it.
Well, Super Bus Project Mark 2, Episode 1.
Hey guys, welcome to the Super Bus Project Mark 3.
We've made it. We're at the motorist check-in on the English side. Hopefully about to board a ferry.
Hi there. My name is David Noe, and in 2010 I bought a Renault Trafic and started converting it into a camper van.
And as you could probably see if we come around here, ooh, isn't it exciting? We've got a bed! Whee! We made that out of a pallet that someone down the doctor's surgery gave to us, and this is going to be the bathroom of sorts, but it will need a lot of waterproofing.
I'd been watching a lot of Jamie Mansell's videos, and I kind of like the idea of the whole living off the grid thing, and my original idea with this was to create a vehicle with like solar panels and stuff like that, and just drive and take it wherever I wanted to take it. Nobody could take it away from me because it would be my super bus, my vehicle, it belonged to me.
So, we need a screwdriver and to jam into that hole. So. Bang, and then we can drill where it's marked out. Yeah.
Okay.
But don't tell anyone. We're just going to put all our shower water down the nearest drain because it's just going to sink out the bottom of the van. But shh, don't tell anyone. Ta-da! Wardrobe completed. Yeah.
I couldn't have done the Super Bus project without my friends, Fredders and Nick in particular, but a special mention also has to be made to Cashman and Chris up in Yorkshire, who got in touch on YouTube to register their interest, and we've been friends ever since.
Hey! Sorry, I haven't quite got used to using this as a video camera yet. Today, I don't know if you can see the grinder up there, but today we're, Alright, on my own, I'm actually doing work for once. I've dug the grinder out so we could do some repairs on the roof.
But, as you can probably tell, regardless of their help, we were in way over our heads.
Okay, so Nick's been painting the dining room table to make it look more dining room table-y.
So we're having a bit of a Jamie Mansell moment. What we're going to do is we're going to cut this scrap metal into strips and then use it as the things to weld the plates in between, basically. So that'll be that. And then the back doors will hopefully never open again.
Unfortunately, things don't always go to plan.
So here's our exploded engine that we're going to take out. It's kind of difficult to see, but it is a total wreck.
Neither of us being qualified engineers, we still had quite a lot of fun removing the old engine, and it didn't take as long as you might think.
From when we got the last bolt undone to the wrenching and the racketing.
We'd originally got an engine from Chris up in Yorkshire. We'd managed to swap some stuff and get the engine for a pretty good deal, but we later found out that it didn't fit, so we had to find another engine on the internet somewhere.
Then we need an engine! Help! It's very early morning, about 8-9 o'clock-ish, which is early for me, and the engine arrived quite early, which meant my dad had to turn around from work, or golf, whatever it was he was doing, and come back and help us with this. two scaffolding poles and a pallet truck later, and here we are. New engine next to the Super Bus. So the engine's getting a scrub down with the gunk, getting all the oil off of it.
So this is preparation for the heart transplant.
In. It just needs screwing, bolting, wiring, plumbing, and then that's it. Job is good. Thanks to some super information from one of our viewers, we now know how the wiring loom should go in here. Thank you so much, you are a huge help. Broken. Not broken. We're now attaching this thing. I don't know what it is. Some kind of field of delivery system. Okay, so while replacing the battery terminals, this came out and this end just wasn't attached to anything.
There were some low moments when putting the new engine in, but also some high points too.
Look! 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 There's a light on the dashboard! Yes! Finally, some engine progress! From the start of my world. Okay, we're going back to work now. See you in a sec. Bye! The horn don't work. We got a battery light as well. Try. Oh my god! Oh, Freddy turned over! Yes! She lives! Yes! Fucking finally! Yes! You did it, how do you feel? We did it, yes!
That clip still makes me cry.
We've been working on the Super Bus all day with Cashman. Well, we haven't, we've been standing around in the background watching him as he works his magic. And amazingly, he's got it running. He got the van working. There you go, the Renault Trafic runs, works. Thank you so much for your help yesterday, Cashman. You're a legend.
Things looked like they were going pretty well, but then I got caught out on all the details.
So this is all finished and complete, but if you come down here, you can see it hasn't really got a bumper. And that's the main reason we haven't taken it for its MOT yet, is because it needs a bumper. But as soon as we get that, we'll go and get it MOT'd.
Sadly, the Super Bus never got that bumper, and later that year I sold it with a view to getting a better, bigger, more complete bus. And unfortunately that didn't happen either. Not for a very, very long time.
Well, Super Bus Project Mark 2, Episode 1. Welcome back, guys. It's been a long time, 5 years since I last uploaded the very first Super Bus video. We spent 6 hours yesterday driving this vehicle back from Yorkshire, up north. We live down in Essex. This is the Super Bus Mark 2. It was a festival camper originally. Chris used to use it as a festival camper to take people, or to have people come join him while he was enjoying, I think it was a folk fest. Renault Master, I think it's called. I think it's a Renault Master. The last one was a Trafic, so much smaller. But yeah, So guys, Super Bus Mark 2. I hope you're as excited as I am. I cannot wait. I'm still a bit worn out from the journey. I'm hoping that a couple of my friends like Nick and Fredders will be over later and I will show them the Super Bus and they'll give me their ideas. But yeah guys, Mark 2, it's back. I'm so glad we're back, man. I cannot wait. And then this is the tickets of freedom, innit? Do you know what I mean? Get this sorted out. Let's do this. Come on, KnuxVeeone, Super Bus Mark 2. 100%. Let's get it done.
As you can probably tell, we had Chris to thank for the new Super Bus. We went up to Yorkshire and traded a laptop and a few other pieces for the new van and got to work on it pretty much straight away.
And I hope the camera's in the right position. But yeah, we've got all the cleaning utensils. And Peacemaker's joined me. Say hello, Peace.
Hello.
And yeah, we're going to just start clearing this place out, basically. And yeah, we'll get back to you. So enjoy.
Okay, so Peacemaker the legend has actually managed to take out the wooden bed that was there before with the metal frame on top. Just having a look at the floor, we took the unit out, as we previously stated, it's over there now. We took the carpet out, and Peacemaker's just done a fantastic job of sweeping all this up.
As usual, I'm leaving my tools all over the place.
We're going to get on, we're going to take this cabin
rack. Me and Peacemaker have managed to take out this section, the overhead compartment.
Okay,
up here.
Hello! Sorry, the battery ran out on the camera, so we've done so much stuff, or more rather, I've just been cutting bits of wood. And Peacemaker's been framing up the frame for the sink and hob unit down there.
Peacemaker's finally finished his
He's finally finished his little cooker table. I don't know if you guys can see that, but we have got all the lights on that we can. But yeah, that's the it needs a second shelf put it in down the bottom there so the cooker can sit on it. But then this will go up against this wall here next to the cooker or next to the wood stove. And it'll be nice and sturdy, and then there'll be a fridge underneath the sink side. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of the Super Bus. I'm here with Fredders today. And say hello.
Hello.
And yeah, so we've got some plans drawn up here for what we're hoping will eventually become the Super Bus. What's interesting is we managed to find this. And those of you from the old series will remember that this used to be the bit of wood up the top there. You can still see the hinges. This used to be the bit of wood that held up the bathroom in the original Super Bus and its door, holding the door on and all that good stuff. So yeah, you can see the mastic and all the mess we made. So there you go. There's the lower part for the bathroom door. And yeah, so that's the start of our frame pretty much, huh?
Yeah.
So that's going to be really cool. So that's the bathroom.
We've shortened the tongue and groove that was all the way out to the end there. So all these offcuts down here used to be up there. And Fredders has done an absolutely fantastic job of framing it all in, making it look fantastic and neat.
So now we've got a bit more wall room and all that good stuff over there to work with. Alright guys, so this is the bathroom shell pretty much. We've just got to do that side bit around there.
How strong is that? So there you go, that is the framing pretty much done for the...
Woohoo!
That's the framing done for the bathroom, much stronger and sturdier than the last one in the Super Bus Mark 1.
And then if we look over here, Fred Wan has been very, very hard at work. He's literally sitting on his creation as well. And there you go, so that's the flower shore? That is the flower shore, Fredders. Shower
Sweet.
Floor. So yeah, he's been hard at work on that and it looks fantastic. I've stood up in it several times and it can definitely hold my weight, so it shouldn't have any problems.
We are finally walling in the bathroom. How cool does that look? So obviously, we're going to mastic it in, we're going to put the lino on, we're going to do all that bits and pieces, but yeah, we're getting there. And while Fred's been doing that, I have been hard at work doing the sort of cutting down the bits of wood and making sure they fit in here.
We've also temporarily put this in to see how it will look,
and to be honest with you, I don't think it looks too bad.
He's been very hard at work today. He's managed to put the floor in, or the first bit of the flooring in.
Work on the Super Bus Mark 2 was progressing pretty quickly, and I was thankful to have a lot of help from my friends.
Me and Fredders have just put the basis of the bed in. We've now got to make a frame for the front, so So this one is fixed in place. This one is permanent.
Look at this bad boy. That's the sofa.
And underneath there's going to be the storage. So then we're going to have an extra, there's going to be a second frame and that will pull
out. Okay, so we have finally made the bed.
Yeah. It doubles up as a sofa. We've still got tons of walking room around here.
All right, guys, I've finished putting this box section together and I cut a couple of slats. So this is basically going to be the little sort of two-person, one-person seat slash single bed.
This is the startings of the desk. So we're going to have two long ones at the back and a little shelf on top. And then at the front here, we're also going to have... So this is going to be where the desk sits on top of these two.
That's going to be where I write my books from now on and do typing and all that good stuff, laptop table.
We might have a slide-out stool or something there, or just a bench that you can move about. And there's also this really cool-looking shelf at the back here. So now what we can do is we can charge off both batteries. We can charge up both batteries, the one in the van and the one on the leisure battery. Via the main house plug.
You'll see that Fred Wan has actually got the desk in and it looks all neat and amazing and he's just siding it all in now. The shelf is on at the top there, the desk itself is together, so that's amazing. He's braced it all in.
It was also pretty nice when my other friends came and paid the bus a visit and helped out every now and then. That was a really cool thing.
He's just out there at the minute. In fact, let's take the camera out and let's see what Kylo is working on.
Going on, brother.
So out here,
there he is, the man.
Out here, we are currently working on building out the ceiling, basically. So Kyle's here cutting the ceiling. We're gonna wrap it in felt once it's all cut, stick it up in the ceiling, and then that'll be it then. Job done, hopefully. Well, what do you think to that then, folks? Ceiling, two ceilings.
Eventually we found a set of solar panels that was going pretty cheap. They averaged around 90 watts in total or 100 watts in total. So that was a pretty good haul.
This morning, me and my dad went on a bit of a road trip and we managed to get these bad boys. And there's two there. There's two there as well. So we got a total of four of these bad boys.
Okay, so here are our new batteries, two golf cart batteries.
If you come over here, you can see the gas connector. We need to extend one of these.
Okay, so we're just finishing up here for the day, and as you can see, we have had a lot of work done today. It's awesome. We've got the power area boxed in. We've just got to do a front up there, and then that'll be sweet. That's pretty much all that finished. Fred's just drying everything all over the bus like a crazy fool. But he's got reason to, because he is putting in the main wall at the back here.
As good as all this progress may have seemed at the time, Renault were not through with me yet.
Batteries back in and tighten them down securely, and unfortunately the van still isn't starting. This has been sort of an ongoing problem. We needed to jump the van every now and then, and sometimes the batteries weren't holding charge, but we think we found a couple of good ones this time. But unfortunately, every time we go to start the van now, that box that you are now zoomed in on, it just keeps clicking repeatedly.
Making the same mistake we'd made with the Super Bus Mk. 1, we continued work on the interior, ignoring the engine.
Okay guys, so we are done for another day in the Super Bus project. We got the light in on the kitchen, not too sure if you can see that, but it is glowing very bright. That's just off the ZIG unit as well, so that's kind of cool. But the most important part is this door. How cool is that? We finally separated the bathroom from the rest of the cab.
We then went and got on with the carpet and the flooring because we got some carpet tiles donated very generously by my dad, which was nice of him.
So it might not look like it, but we're about to finish up cleaning this thing. There's only a few little bits of metal in there that I've got to grab out with my hand.
Ignoring the engine problems, things on the Super Bus Mk. 2 were actually pretty relaxing. Unfortunately, you can't ignore those problems forever. And as cosy as the Super Bus Mk. 2 was, it wasn't going anywhere.
Hey there guys, I've tried to record this video about 6 times now, and every time I say the wrong thing and I start tripping over my words. So I'm just gonna focus on this one and come out and say it. The Super Bus, it's gonna cost far too much for me to repair this bus.
far too much. Like, we've had an auto technician out to fix the immobiliser and he couldn't do it. We've done loads of other stuff with the immobiliser trying to get it work. We can't find the number in the key to get it working. Even then, we can't get the immobiliser working again. So what we're going to do instead, this isn't the end of the Superbus project. I know last video I was like, oh, we're not going to give up on this. We're not really giving up on the Superbus project. We're just sort of, I'll take my hat off. This bus has defeated me. This bus has totally ruined me. I'm a bit pissed off because me and Fred have put time into two vans now and we've got nothing to show for it.
Watching a second bus go to the scrapyard was pretty tough. Help from some family friends made it a bit easier, but not being able to use it for camping after all that work was still pretty disappointing. Soon, my dad found a solid Ford Transit. I believe it was well looked after for a work van. We bought it after a test drive and it became known as the Superbus Mk. 3 from then on.
Hey there guys, welcome to the Superbus Project Mk. 3. We've got a new van. It's a Ford Transit, so not a Renault Master this time.
The plan had changed significantly since the Superbus Mk. 1. We were now creating a vehicle that we could drive around and look for locations that could potentially become off-grid sites for building. So a place to set up my home, pretty much. And this time, I was determined to do things the right way.
Apologise for the noise, but tonight, or today even, we are on top of the Superbus, dealing with these rather nasty rust spots. Alright guys, I have done all the paintwork on the outside that I can do today. I went over the roof and gave it a really thick coat, so hopefully in this weather it will dry real quick and yeah, I won't have any problems with rust on the roof in the future. And if I do, I got a tin of anti-rust paint now, so that's all good. Here is the plan.
And today, I am fiddling and faffing and trying to install this. This is a reversing camera, and I'm sticking it up here. So when it's in, it'll look like this. You won't see the wire, and then pa-pow, and it'll be sort of in the same place as you would find a rear view mirror.
I don't know if this drill is going to be strong enough to get through there, but we'll see.
There you go.
Oh yeah, look, there it is. Hole for the camera. Now when I put the camera in, hopefully the wire will just dangle down and I'll be able to connect it up.
That would be a working reverse camera. How cool is that nonsense?
Okay, so that's my front door and the lovely selection of houseplants to the left, I guess that is. It should be on the right. It's so weird. But yeah, so the reversing camera works and that's going to go up on the dashboard like push, and then I'll be able to look at it and be like, right.
Well. Hey there guys, welcome back to another episode of the Superbus project with myself, KnuxVeeone, and today I'm going to try and assemble some of this nice, fresh, new wood into, and some of the old stuff as well, into a bed.
Sorry for that unscheduled cut there. The camera ran out of battery and it started to rain, so I ran inside, charged everything up, and now we're back. I'm going to get back on with this. You didn't really miss much. I just made the other leg section up. So I'm going to get back on, put it all together, make a few more of these sections, and I should be sweet. So I
just made up another one of those things. I'm now getting to work on the interior slats that go in the gaps here that slide out to make the bed.
Okay, so after a considerable amount of time of sanding and planing the back edge to allow the boards to fit in there properly, that is the first half of the bed.
Okay then guys, that's the sofa pretty much built. All we've got to do is put a front on it now and that'll be sweet. We're going to put either some plyboard on it, wallpaper, that sort of thing, or some tongue and groove if we can find enough of it. But
Massive thanks to my dad for helping me today with this.
Eventually it's going to be attached at the back and there are going to be hinges. And they're going to do that. It'll be like a car boot, so you'll have like a bit of a cover there. So you'll only be able to get into it from this sort of way.
No! No! Not now! Not now! Come on! Please! I know you've got some life left in you. No! No! Fine, I'll do the rest with screwdriver.
Today, I wanted to get on with the bathroom, but first, before I do that, I've got to sort out this ceiling.
So, I've done this. This is all spirit levelled in, although probably me leaning against it and poking it and has thrown it all off, so I'll have to check that again.
Okay, so there's one part of it done. I've just got to do the top bit now, and the curve, and maybe like one support in the middle to sort of bring the curve this way. Okay, so as you can see, this is coming along. So the next thing to do, is put a bit from there to there, and then attach a bit from there to there to there, and then to the end bit, so it's got that curve to it. And there you have it. It's not in there properly yet, obviously it's not lined up in that, but it fits, and the angle is good, and everything's awesome. I am very happy. So now I've got to take it out again, like this one, and I'm going to cover them in wood seal.
But check this out.
Oh, isn't it amazing? It's like a freaking double bed. You crazy, man?
This one seems to have a few problems. I think I might need to still sand this down a little bit. But yeah, there you go, look at that, isn't it amazing?
Okay, so that's the sofa pretty much done. All I've got to do is put a cover on this, sew it up, and that way I've got myself a pretty neat bed there, so I just pull it out, that mattress comes with it, sort of, and then job done, somewhere to sleep. Fantastic. Huge thanks to DR and everyone else who helped with this. I really appreciate it. Ta-da! And thanks to my dad, we haven't even had to cut grooves in here yet. He gave me a huge help with this, and I really appreciate that. So that's the last of the fake walls, stud walls, whatever you want to call them, done. So now I can start panelling stuff in. Da-da-da-da. Okay, there are two stacks of tongue and groove that has been cut. All right then, guys, here we go. There is one side of the bed complete.
What is this? I will tell you what this is.
This is the fully complete sofa with the fronts on it. Ta-da, isn't that amazing? That gap's a bit big, but it's okay because you can move these over. Close it up a little bit. Move that back. Get in there. So yeah, we have completed the sofa. Alright guys, I think that's going to be it for me today. I've got to go plyboard these and that's going to be quite a mission. So hopefully I'll get that done before the next episode.
Welcome back to another episode of the Super Bus with myself, KnuxVeeone. And guess who got the radio working? Yeah!
Okay, I'll turn
it down. Right, so I've decided to do the electronics since we've got all the parts. And what I've got to do now is I've got to take these, add them to these, and connect these batteries up in parallel so that they provide twice as much time.
Alright guys, the batteries are wired in parallel, and now we've also got the solar charge control unit here as well. So if we flick this on,
it is now attached to the box. So now all I have to do is out of the way of the solar thing, so I can flick this on and still see all the numbers on there, which is very nice, very nice.
Although the display isn't on, if I click that, there you go, it's on now. I can turn all that off.
And then obviously this, to replace the fuses, I just undo this. Isn't it magical? And then there you go.
My dad just came in looking for tools in my toolbox and he hasn't tidied it up. Ah, now I know how it feels. Ah. Anyway, ignoring that, the inverter, solar power. Look at these bad boys.
So these are the solar panels we picked up during the Super Bus Mk 2.
Our batteries are charging.
Okay, Fred is doing some woodwork. Amazing. What we've decided to do is we're going to put additional beam across the tops of all three of these stud walls. So like across there. And that'll give it a bit more support when, like, if we accidentally fall into it or knock it and things like that. And it'll also make it a lot easier for us to put these in because they won't be sort of creaking and groaning as we're trying to sort all this stuff out.
Here we have
the frame for the kit for the bathroom kitchen for the shower wet room site deal that we're doing.
Okay, so test one.
Zap is a success. Yeah, I just got electrocuted. Yeah, 12 volts of glorious goodness. And this also means that we don't need this switch down here anymore. So yeah, that's the first one working. I can't believe I just electrocuted myself, what an idiot.
So there's one of them. Does it still work?
Yeah, and what's the voltage gone down to? Straight down to 13 volts.
Please excuse the power ride.
I've taken out the carpet here, even though I didn't really want to, but we've got to get through this floor. What we're going to do is we're going to get through this floor. We're going to feed a pipe through next to the wheel arch, so you can still get it, get a bucket under there, get whatever. It would have been nice to have sort of like a hose that you can pull out and extend. Rick Van Man, if you check out his shower system, he's got one, an extendable hose that just goes to the back of the bus, and that takes his wastewater away, and then he can dump it off separately. But in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to have a pipe like this, feeding from the drain, and it's just going to drain out straight into the bottom.
I have been on an epic quest to the land of Basildon and have retrieved this lino vinyl stuff.
Do not be alarmed, humans, it is only I. Put this safety equipment on. I'm going to go under the bus. I'm going to drill out a hole, and then I'm going to use this fancy equipment here,
courtesy of my father. Now we might do it with that, or I might drill a couple of holes and then jigsaw, but I don't know how well the jigsaw will go through metal, so we're gonna see.
Okay, in keeping with this episode's silly hat wear theme, I've decided to go upstairs and get my headphones because they are literally the only source of sound protection I have while I am drilling these holes. And just so you know, let's do this. That is for the 230 volt power supply. Oh, holy moly. Yeah.
Right then, as you beautiful people can see here, here is the 230 in, fitted by my awesome father. This shit is messy, horrible. Some of the benefits it's got going for it is it's easy to cut and it insulates. So this is what we're using to insulate the walls.
Ha ha! Isn't it exciting? Insulation. And this will also act as a sort of extra support, so whenever someone leans up against the wall, it's got let, like, there's no, not going to be any caving or anything like that, so this is sweet. Thank you, Nick!
There's one of them doodads. There's the other. You can see they've been nailed in. Nick's out there with a jigsaw cutting up that piece for the back there. Then he's got to do one more. And then we've got to do these two side bits, and then we should be sweet.
Check it out. It is completed.
Oh, done. Like, there's this door here. That's all been sealed. All the bathroom's been masticked and sorted out, so that's sweet.
Just thinning down the door.
Then we're going to sand it. Oh, actually, we're going to chisel out the places for these rather nice hinges.
Okay, so this is the golf cart battery charger, and in there are the golf cart batteries themselves. Both the same make and model and what have you, and I think this is the charger that originally came with them. Obviously, since my dad no longer uses these batteries, he no longer needs this charger. He's got new batteries and new charger and what have you. So we're going to install this, but I'm going to make sure it's easy to switch it on and off, and I might even make it so it's easy to disconnect as well, I don't know yet. But this is the golf cart battery charger, and this will also sort of act as like a ZIG unit kind of thing for charging these batteries, but these batteries are locked.
Check out this bad boy, how cool is he? Yeah. So now we've got pretty much a working water system in the bus. We've already got the tube in.
Okay, so I just borrowed a fuse from the lights to test this.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. We run all the way back here. Here is the pump. We've already tested it. It's very exciting. Here is the switch for the sink in the kitchen. Da-da-da-da.
Oh, isn't it amazing? I'm not going to run it for ages, because I don't know if you should run them dry.
Well, we wait for the door to dry. Construction has started on the kitchen. Ooh, isn't it exciting? One half completed door. Now all I've got to do is nail in the four corners and a bit in the middle, and then we've got to flip it over and cut another one of these. So yeah. Okay, so the kitchen is slowly going in. We're just making all the legs for it now. We're not going to have a leg on this far corner because A, there's no wood to screw into on this corner, and second of all, the bed might interact with it. So if the bed doesn't, then we'll eventually put like a cabinet or something under there, and then that will support that
so
corner.
So if we follow this mad cap contraption all the way up here, you can see that we've sort of been testing it a little bit, and then it works! Please excuse all singing voices. How amazing is that? We have got running water in a super bus for the first time. Not including that weird blue shower thing we had. This is proper running water for a tap.
We need to plane this door down some more, but it's almost ready. Look at that, isn't it amazing? And then we're going to put a shower curtain on the inside after we've done all the sort of lino vinyl stuff. Okay, guys, there we go. One door is in place. It still needs a door handle. I have to open it from the bottom here, but check that out, and it bounces all the way back, so you can still access it when the you can access the back door and everything. Okay, so the fire extinguisher from the Super Bus Mk. 1 is in next to the kitchen. How amazing! And what else did I want to say? Oh yeah, one of my drill bits broke. I think it was the 3mm one as well. The one I use the most, of course it is. Okay guys, the floor is in. Massive thanks to my dad for that. So yeah, the floor's in. We haven't been able to put this in yet because the thread catches it and then it doesn't. So we're going to silicone this in, and that's going to be the way to do
that. Right, I'm in my least favourite place on the bus, on the roof. So filming is going to be very short and sweet up here. I've got my first solar panel. I'm going to cover it in Sikaflex, flip it over, drill the holes, put the screws in, and that should be it. Job done. Right, that's number one in place. Awesome. Now I've got three more to do. There's number three. Right, there's number four. Now if I've got this right, we are currently running on solar power. Those four panels up on the roof now are providing 13-ish volts of electricity. Well, there you go guys, the first wall is in. I'm probably not going to do a video for every one of these, but that's the first one. And hopefully next time you see us, it'll be this one. And that'll be that. We're now getting on with putting the table in, and luckily for us, someone's already drilled a hole in this part of the van, so all we've really got to do is make this bigger. I've been under the van to check it to make sure there's enough space under there. We're not going to hit anything like the exhaust or the petrol tank or all that or any of that nonsense. So we've got a place to put our table now, so we're going to get on with that, and yeah, once it's in, I'll be happy to show you. Massive thanks to Peacemaker for his donation of a TV for the super bus. So now all the other bits can go in now, electronics wise, so we've got a screen to watch them all on now, so that's cool.
Check it out, the bathroom is done.
We've just got to wait after 10 minutes, we'll just stick that up and that's done, finished, finito. Then we screw the light back up and I put the shower in. You'll notice that the door's off. It's currently getting planed down some more. Between my mum and dad, they all managed to get this up as well, so I've got a little bit of a privacy curtain here now, which is cool. And then there's the table, so it's all coming together. I can't believe it, it's amazing. I'm a bit lost for words, to be honest with you. So yeah,
all right guys, we are back, the final episode of the Super Bus Project build episodes. From now on it's going to be touring. Look at this, it's done, it's finished, it's roadworthy, camp worthy. I'll run you through it quickly, a little tour. It is very hot today, so excuse me if I'm all over the place. These are two 20 litre water jugs. They go into the pump here. Pump follows down and goes into the kitchen. This is a gas locker. It has our gas tank in it and also loads of mastic, because I intend to seal up the edges at a later date. But we've also got a downpipe here. This goes out of the van, so all the gas in there. This gas is heavier than air, so it will go to the lowest point. The gas that's coming off the batteries is not, so I need to reseal them. The gas that comes off the batteries is lighter than air, so you need to be more careful about that. In this box is all kitchen cleaning stuff, utensils, that kind of thing. Down there, that's going to be for cold goods if I ever get any.
This bucket is the drainage for the sink, so whenever you want to empty the sink out, it will just go straight into this bucket, and then I empty the bucket out. 60 granola bars, because why not? Then in here we've got my gas cooker. This is all hooked up now anyway. I've got to get like a metal hood and then an extraction fan to take this out. Up there's my hammock with all my clothes in it, and that sits nicely above the door. And now whenever I bang my head, it's very soft. We've got this bit of metal plating at the back there as well. So these three crates of food, and it seems like pasta and cup of soups and whatever, your long-lasting foods. And then over here, that bag's all my tools. So nobody steal this. Right next to the door, so it's easy to grab and run off with. I'm hoping that it's got so much stuff on top of it that nobody's going to bother. There's the step, some more cooking utensils. There's the soda stream. I'm taking that with me so I can make Dr. Pete. These are my shoes, obviously. And then if we turn around here, this is the table. And that's got all my junk on it. And then up here we've got a netting to hold this in. You slide that bar out there and then you can lift that up and look at all the stuff in there and get to what you need and what have you, basically. Already done the table. My computer's going to be going under here. This is the last job that we need to do, is put the computer under there, but I won't be doing that until 4 o'clock tomorrow morning, because at about 5 o'clock I'll be leaving to go to the Hook of Holland, so Harwich to the Hook of Holland, and then from there I'll be doing my tourist videos. So under here, we've got all sorts of bits and pieces. There's my life's work, basically, in the Chaos Nova notes and stuff down there. I was donated this sleeping bag by a very good friend, so thanks for that. That's awesome of you. Yeah. And then the bathroom. Now the bathroom also needs one more thing. We've sorted the lip down there kept coming up, so we've put a bar across there. And then we've got this. This is the shower, toilet down there, more toiletries there, and we've got the shower curtain now as well, so we don't have to worry about the door getting wet. I didn't do the door in the end. I think the shower curtain will protect it enough, so if I put that over there, do that, and close that. So yeah, that's pretty much about it. Oh yeah, we've got door handles and nice to stop it flapping about and that, and if I ever get accidentally trapped in here, I'm sure I can kick this off. But yeah. The last thing I'm going to do is hoover, finish off the drain, because the drain down there, I don't know if you can see it, it's all in and that, it's all good, it just needs the top half putting on, so like the silver disc putting on. I've got a spare truck battery basically in there to go with that one. That's the main one. This is a spare, so if anything goes wrong, I'm good. All the power stuff is under there. Let me see if I can get that in there. So that's the power box. All fuses and everything. And I just want to say a massive thank you to all the people who have helped with this project. Fredders, Peacemaker, oh, there's so many. DR, Law, Rue, everyone. Everyone who's helped with this project, especially my mum and my dad. They have been absolutely legendary for helping me sort this out. Like, they sorted out the curtains and what have you. And I've already spent 3 nights in here. Oh, whoops, I've just pulled that down. Let me just put the curtain up and then I'll put the rail back up. There we go. Right, and then, oh, I'm all over the place. It's because I'm excited. And then that's that curtain in place. There you go, some privacy there now then. But yeah, just a massive, massive thank you to everyone who's helped me. I really honestly couldn't have done this without any of you. The first Super Bus was originally conceived about 5 or 6 years ago. I think it's coming up to 6, maybe even 7 years now. And that one failed. And then the second one broke and that failed. But now finally this third one is still running. It's all complete, it's camp worthy. And I've booked tickets to Europe. So I'm going to begin my Euro trip soon. And I'm hopefully going to go see some of the friends I've got in Europe and beyond. So yeah, Cashman, you're a legend. Digital Reaper, you're a legend. My parents, you're all legends. Just everybody who's helped me with this, you're just so amazing. I can't put into words how thankful I am for all of you. Thank you so much. It's done, we're finished, we're going to Europe.
So, we'd finally built a working camper van, and what better way to test it than a round trip through Europe to Estonia, starting at Harwich. I should probably point out that before this, I'd never stayed at a campsite in a vehicle before, and I was travelling alone. At the time, though, I was more excited than scared.
We've made it. We're at the motorist check-in on the English side. Hopefully about to board a ferry onto, into the Hook of Holland. So, yeah.
But yeah, this is Harwich.
And we'll be leaving here soon, and I think we're heading, I imagine, in that direction, but I could be horribly wrong. With Dover, when you leave Dover to go to France, or Dover to Calais, it's quite easy to know what direction you've got to go in, because it's just off whatever direction the White Cliffs aren't. You go in the opposite direction to the White Cliffs and you end up in France.
Send someone on a mission to
get there. We're here. They haven't called my level yet, so we're just going to chill out and wait for them to call my level, basically, and then I'm going to head out.
First stop, Rotterdam.
I'm so exhausted, you would not believe. So exhausted, but we made it. Oh, it smells so nice here. It smells like beautiful nature, and look how much space we got to ourselves, man. Right, well, this is the first day at a campsite. I'm very tired, it's been very hot all day, but I'm here and I'm settled, sort of. I just gotta pull the bed out when I'm ready to go to bed, and that'll be it. So yeah, I'm gonna sit, chill, read for a little bit, and then I'm gonna go to bed, and then I'll get on with my adventures tomorrow.
Rotterdam is a beautiful, if somewhat confusing, place to navigate, but I managed it in the end and I had a wonderful time.
Look at this place, man. This is the park just down the road from the campsite. Here's all my stuff on the bench over there. That's safe, isn't it? But look at this place. Over there somewhere is a fallen tree. You could probably see it. And that's leaning into the river. And it's another very hot day today. Unbelievably so. So yeah, I'm gonna go find some breakfast and I will catch you up soon. Okay, I've come around to the back of the van to enjoy my breakfast. I think at lunchtime I'm gonna go find a proper supermarket and buy some butter, ham, and maybe a tomato or two.
While generally everything was pretty good, loneliness was becoming a massive factor.
I don't know if it's just because I'm reading that and he is very alone, very isolated, that I also too, now in the camper van as I'm going across Europe, feel very isolated as well.
But thankfully, I was due to meet some friends the following day in Amsterdam.
Sorry, I haven't had a video up in the past couple of days. It's been a very busy one. I went to the Heineken Museum with a couple of friends. And then we went to a boat museum yesterday. Oh, we've been doing so much stuff. It's been mad. It's sort of been a mad rush. I had sushi the other day. I had to fill in a bloody theory test before I could order me food because I didn't know. It's the way you order food in a sushi restaurant. A proper sushi restaurant's a bit different to what we're used to in the UK, so that was an experience. While my noodles cook, I thought I'd explain to you why I'm doing my clothing like this. It's just the campsite. So many people here. It's not really that busy up this end of the campsite, but down the other end where all the stuff is, like the washing machines, the dryers, and the main toilets, things like that. So it's absolutely rammo down there, and I couldn't get in there to do my washing and laundry that way, so that's where everything's hanging up, soaking at the back of the van. I don't know how long this is going to take. Okay, so sadly Kaylee and Kyle and Tilbrook and the crew have all gone home. It was an absolute pleasure meeting their friend Jay as well, and Cliff. They were pretty cool. They've travelled a long way to come here. I think they were from Thailand originally, and then they got visas in the UK, and then they've come over here, and that was cool to meet them. They're pretty interesting people, very friendly too. So I'm just chilling with Law, figuring out the next leg of my journey, but I've also got dinner on the go. I'm having pasta tonight, so yeah. Right, well, here's the super bus chilling in Field B in Amsterdam. That PowerPoint is in exactly the wrong place, so I have to keep moving it whenever I open a door. But today, I'm going to take you on a tour of the campsite, so let's go check this out. Look at these guys. This isn't my campsite. Hello. I don't have any food for you. I'm just here to record you. Hello. Please don't hurt me. Hello.
Oh wow. So yeah, we've got goats at the campsite. It's kind of crazy, isn't it? And occasionally you'll see chickens roaming around. Okay, so I apologise if all you can hear is the wind, but this little area down here is literally, like the campsite's there. So it's a 2 minute walk out to here, and this is where I like to come and relax sometimes. And like I say, I apologise if the wind, I'll try and cover it up. I'm probably not doing a great job, but yeah. So yeah, this sign points that direction for Centrum, but I don't know, because I always have to get the tram. I'm not calling the sign a liar, but there you go. I don't know, I couldn't confirm. And also, these are the worst stairs I've ever had to contend with in my life. They're too big for a normal step. So obviously the Dutch love cycling everywhere, their country's pretty flat. And that's so you can get your bikes up and down real easy on the stairs. Now look, over there's the campsite, and I'm gonna go up there to get a shot. So there we are on top of the bridge. You can see the campsite down there. There's where you can bring the bike from there. Super bus is over in that direction somewhere, I think. Yeah, so this is the reception down here, and then that way is all the places for the camping camper vans. And then further over that way you got all the tents, and then down there's all like the eco huts, I think, and what have you. And then down here is all bike rental and stuff like that, so you can obviously you can rent a bike if you want.
Out of all the campsites on my trip, City Camp was easily my favourite.
And unfortunately tomorrow I'm gonna have to move on. Sorry, our campsite is full, frowny face. So I was looking at the alternatives, because they've given me this nice leaflet and sort of said, look, there are alternatives, and there are a couple of good ones. I've looked at Gaspar before, it's quite expensive, and I've checked that one out. But this one was the most interesting to me. It's Amsterdam City Camp, and it's only for campers. There's no toilets, there's no showers. Okay, we've made it to the new campsite. This is City Camp Amsterdam. Just as I imagined, it is basically a car park. Car park and an industrial estate in a foreign country. The inverter is successfully charging the laptop, or rather the solar panels are charging the batteries, and then the inverter's taking that power and making it so the 240 volt, whatever, can use it. So I'm charging my laptop.
City Camp was pretty unique in that I had to take a boat whenever I wanted to go to Amsterdam City Central.
That's what we're on now, one of them. That's going back to the same dock we've just come away from. So there you go.
It was also at City Camp where I met the friendliest couple you could ever hope to meet.
A couple of very nice Italian people have rocked up next to me. They're not here at the moment, those are just some empty seats that belong to the nice Italian people. And yeah, they're just really friendly and really nice and kind, and they've said I can sit out there and get on the laptop out there if I want.
Okay, I've just been shopping because I've been walking around loads in the city and I'm eating more than I usually would at home. So I've been shopping again, more ham and cheese, and I've also got some bacon this time as well and some steaky type things. So I'm going to cook them tonight. And I've also got some fruit, and this is all very, very cheap. Considering, like, this was €2.47 for that. And so yeah, it's very cheap. I think it cost me less than €25 for all of this. So I'm going to have a steaky and salad type meal tonight, and then probably some fruit to wash it down with. So there we go, success.
So today we're going to do a little tour of the NDSM wharf, which is where we are, which is where I'm staying, the campsite just down the road, City Camp. And I better do this today because I'm leaving later. I'm going with the Italians to a different campsite further north in Holland, so that should be interesting. It's going to be good fun. This place used to produce massive ships back in the 19th and 20th centuries, before the industry went bust, and then this area sort of just got abandoned basically, so there's nothing here. And then loads of squatters and artists moved in and started claiming the place for their own, And that building you see in front of me now used to build ships, but now it's like the home for an art gallery, basically. And if I walk down here a little bit, you can actually see how big it really is. It just goes on for ages. And then there's another building down there as well, which I think is also used for art projects and what have you. I'm informed by the NDSM Wharf website that this is actually a hotel. You can see the rooms up in the middle there, but not only that, apparently it's got a jacuzzi on the roof. And if we zoom in again, I don't really like zooming in, you can almost kind of see it. That is potentially a jacuzzi up there. Oh look, the doors are opening just for us, look at that. Again, we're not going in there, but you can sort of get an idea for what it's like actually. Let's just have a little peek, because I haven't been in here yet. An art space. And then what is all this? The endless rhythm. Oh wow. Be careful to make sure I'm not stepping on anything here. That's amazing. Right, I have made a successful escape. And I haven't got in trouble. So there you go, victory. I also picked up a NDSM magazine for free. They're free, so I thought I'd grab one so I could inform you lovely people of all the corrections in the next video. Yeah. Oh, I've got to show you the submarine. The submarine's awesome. Let me see if I haven't walked down here yet, but I've seen it every time I go out on the boat. Let's go have a look at the submarine. How mad is that? Just, and it just sits there, it doesn't do anything. It just stays there. So God knows. But yeah, you get the boat from over there. And then there's a submarine. And then over in the background there's the motel. But submarine. And we've made it to Dunkerdwenen in the north of Holland. And it's very peaceful here. We're about to go on a little tour of the site. I'm here with my Italian friends. And then further down there's some families down there, and then there's the toilet building. But we're not going that way, we're going this way. Look at this place, isn't it amazing? So peaceful as well. Until someone like me turns up. That's that done. This is the only exit at the campsite to the beach. Any other exit you have to go a long way around. So let's go, and then let's go up this way. And this is basically, my campsite is in the middle of a forest. I think it's Wednesday today and I've extended my stay until Friday. And then after Friday, my Italian friends are going back to a city camp. And I was thinking of doing the same, because while this place is perfect, literally perfect, and so peaceful and quiet, I kind of miss the NDSM wharf. The kind of hustle and bustle of everything that goes on there and all the artwork and what have you. So I don't know, this doesn't feel like a beach, and I've got tangled up in my headphones again. I just got approached by, I think they were a Dutch couple, and we said hello, exchanged friendliness, pleasantries, as you do. And then the woman started asking me a question in Dutch, and I couldn't answer her at all. I was just like, sorry, I'm English. Like, that's the bad thing. Like, sorry, I come from the United Kingdom. Sorry. But yeah, no, I couldn't help them, unfortunately, which is a bit of a shame, but there you go. Maybe they were asking me where the beach was. Maybe they wanted to know where the beach was, just like I want to know where the beach is. So yeah, this reminds me a lot of Hockley Woods in the UK. I tried to explain this to my Italian friends yesterday as well, or the day before, and I couldn't remember the name, and then like 2 hours later, out of nowhere, I was just like, oh, Hockley Woods! And they were like, what are you talking about? And I was like, oh, the woods, I couldn't remember the name of earlier. Looked like a right idiot. So I'll try to refrain from doing that again in the future. This place is cool here on the left. This place looks like, I don't know, a completely different world. Like, you've got this forest here, oh la 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 la, and then you turn around and it looks like a fucking Magic the Gathering card in here. How cool is that? That's awesome, isn't it? Let's see if I can back up a little bit and
I have potentially found the beach. I don't know, maybe. There's sand and there's water. That's my expert analysis of the situation there. But there's potential that we have actually found the beach, but I don't think so, you know. Surely a beach needs a sea, like waves and stuff. That is more of my expert analysis right there for you good people. The lengths I go to make sure there are some facts in these videos. Not very far at all. It's like a little lagoon, isn't it? Is that the right word? Almost like a swamp, I guess. Oh, not really. Maybe not a swamp. If I find out this is the beach, I'm gonna laugh my ass off. But what? No, this ain't a beach. Southend-on-Sea? That's a beach. Right, so I've just got to the top of some sand dunes. The forest is obviously back in that direction. There's a massive like, road football thing down there. And I'm slowly becoming convinced that the beach is just something they tell English tourists to have a laugh with them. Like, I can't do any accents, but you just imagine some very nice tourists and some very nice reception people saying, oh yeah, there's a beach. There's a beach. He'll be looking for it for days. So, yeah. And there are hills over there. Oh, there's a lighthouse. Okay, so that means there's got to be water in that direction. Onward. Onward! But, yeah, it's an adventure. And I know exactly where I've got to go. There's a road just down here. And I follow this for days. Almost weeks. I have to start a log just to make sure I keep track of the days. But, yeah. And that takes me back down to the forest, and then from the forest I turn left. As beautiful as this land may be, even while it's raining, there is still no beach. I've walked from over here somewhere, all the way up here. Here is the main road. Lighthouse is over there. This is my last thing now. If I can't make it to the lighthouse from here and find the beach, then I'm giving up. This is too far. I've walked too far. So there we are, the lighthouse. I think I'm close. I'm gonna keep going. I think I might get a bit lost, but I think I know my way back. We'll see. It's all an adventure, isn't it? Let's do this. I'm gonna get to that lighthouse. Yeah, you damn right. This ground, that ground, lighthouse, all connected. Yeah! I found the lighthouse. Mission accomplished, basically. Now let's see if we can find the beach. This looks a bit steeper than when I wasn't walking up it. Let's, oh shit, okay. Well look, if they can mow it with one of the ride-on mowers, then I can surely walk up it. Come on now. But yeah, it's been a good old adventure today. I've enjoyed this. It ain't even lunchtime, I don't think. Ain't even the afternoon, and I've conquered the northern, well, some northern part of Netherlands. Sounds like a piece of beach, though. Oh, okay. It's not a beach, is it? It's all rocks. Oh, not a proper beach. Oh, the surf. You can't get much more beach than this. There are sand, sea, there are shells, and there's even a little sort of... Look at this! I don't even know what this is, looks like some sort of fortification of some kind. This thing's mental! Just like with the NDSM docks, I'm walking straight in. I don't know about this, but let's do it. Take the risk, make an adventure. God, look at this place. Officer's entry, I think. Officer's latrine. I can't see this. It's as good as the one in the Super Bus. That's excellent. Getting about done with these stairs though, man. Just had to walk up loads from the beach. That was a pain in the ass. Going uphill, not good. Not good for me. Cannons down there. Is that a lighthouse? Some nice little shop thing down there. I need to go and check that out. I was too impressed with this. Slightly nervous to see a little English flag on the invading forces' boats here. I don't know how they've managed to decapitate him from that far away. Maybe a very accurate cannonball, but there you go. I made it back. I'm alive. It's pouring with rain out there, so I've had to change my clothes, and I doubt I'll be doing laundry
today. What we're doing today is basically upgrading the kitchen. We're moving the kitchen down to here so that the open door acts more as a vent, so I can start using the bigger gas tanks.
Look at all this space I've just found from moving this a little bit. How cool is that? So this is all moved now.
I have to move the table so it goes like that, so I've got a bigger walkway through here. But that's fine. It's absolutely awesome, and I think this is going to be much better, much easier to cook on now.
Okay, it's the next day. I've already been to town and sorted everything that I need to sort. I've got food and what have you. And today, since we're back at City Camp, I've decided that I'm going to put a proper end on the shower.
Okay, so that third one there, that's the shower.
You can hear the inverter buzzing away up there, charging my laptop. And if we go in here, oh, it's very dark if we turn the light on. And if I sit down on the toilet and don't break it, if I press this button here, you can hear the pump working. So now all I got to do, whenever I want to shower, I just fill that bucket up with clean water, and I'll probably be really quick about it. I'll cover myself in soap and shampoo and then start the shower, clean it all off and then dry up. So last night there was supposed to be a festival of some sort here, and it was so windy last night that I don't think it happened. I think they had to cancel it, unfortunately. And while I was searching for the laundromat, I saw that the whole of the north of Holland has basically been destroyed by wind and what have you. So there's trees down, there's branches all over everywhere. Let's start a little walk down here, come on. Because of all the damage that's occurred at the NDSM, with like trees coming down and bins being blown over, I'm actually equipped with a bag full of black sacks. So we're going to go down to the thing and have a little bit of a tidy up. So that's pretty cool. But the real reason we're here is for, if we go down here, you see all the wind and stuff is blowing all this shit down here. And I've got some black sacks with me, so we're going to fix this problem. So let's go. Haha, victory is mine. Take that wind, we win this round. Today is raining again. Surprise, surprise. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, let me turn the light on here for a second. I am going to tear this out. I'm going to not tear it out, obviously. I'm going to take the bar off from across there and lift this up. And then I'm going to take all the stuff out from behind there, because there's a box of towels in there that I just completely forgot about that I need. And I'm also going to check the wiring for the solar system, because I've got an odd feeling it's been disconnected somewhere. So let's see what happens. And
okay,
yeah.
Because I'm running on very limited battery resources, I don't like keeping the lights on and things like that, so I prefer using things that I can recharge rather easily. So this thing that I bought on the boat to recharge my phone is very cool. I could just plug it into my laptop, or I can plug it into, if we go over here, the this USB device over here also charges this. It's an out socket for USB basically, so I can charge this sort of stuff up with it. Now I've also got a laptop light. Now if I connect the laptop light up, and I'm going to try and do this with one hand, yes, and then yes, so now I've got myself a little handy personal torch. Like I've got a torch up there somewhere, but it takes the big double D batteries or whatever they're called. So this is a much better solution, combining the laptop light. Look at how bright that thing is with the phone charger. It's just a lithium-ion battery with a connector on the top. These are very useful.
Okay, there has been a slight disaster. Because of the leak, some of my books
have suffered from some water damage, which is a real big shame because these lost fleet books were in perfect condition pretty much before this happened. So I'm gonna let them dry out. I'm gonna get rid of this box completely and move them over to the plastic one. But I'm really upset about this, man. This is my book collection. And I hope if I dry them out and then put them under something heavy, it'll flatten them out again and, you know, damage won't be too bad. But we'll see. This is potentially my new favourite makeshift tool. Look at this bad boy. So I didn't have a gun for the mastic, and I had to apply to some bits outside because I think there's a hole in a couple of places. So I sorted that out, and I sorted the inside out. Okay, so it's our last day at city camp, and after this we're going to Gaspere, and then after that we're going to Groningen. I have made it to Gaspere. I'm very hot, very sweaty, very irritated. I got lost in the campsite. They take your passport off you at the door, and that worried me. The dude who's just cycled past there, he takes your passport off you, and that worried me. And then I went into reception, queued up once, and then the woman behind the desk was like, oh, your passport hasn't arrived here yet. So I had to queue up a second time, and that was not fun because it was very hot in their stuffy little reception room that they've got going on there. And it's so busy here, man. I think city camp definitely wins out just for busyness, but city camp doesn't have a supermarket and showers and all sorts of things like that and toilet facilities. And so really I'm only here to use the facilities, like wash all my clothes and get all that done before I go to Groningen, and then from Groningen I'll be going up to Sweden. But yeah, I just thought I'd come check out Gaspere. I'm sure it's not as bad. I think I just need to chill out and relax and, you know. Okay, so it's the next day and it's raining. Horrifically raining. I'm trying not to capture people. But yes, check it out. I've got lots of stuff to do today. This is the last day in Amsterdam before I go to Groningen. I'm staying here tonight. And then tomorrow I will be leaving and heading towards Groningen.
It's not really anything interesting to show you today. I've just got to do my chores, basically. I've got to do some washing up. I had a lovely dinner last night. Pork chops, salad and egg. I think the eggs are made at Gaspere. I think they're produced at Gaspere. Like, they've got chickens and stuff here, I think.
Welcome back to another episode of Walking with myself, KnuxVeeone. This, how badass is this? I've come from down in that direction. Camping site's over there. And I'm heading this way. Check this out. One little bridge here. How cool is this? This is pretty neat. So I still haven't found the beach. Ah, sorry, wrong episode. I'm here on the edge of this lake. How badass is this? And I'm just in this little enclosed area. It's just like proper private, isn't it? That's cool. Let's check this out. Gaspere is the name of the campsite. G-A-A-S-P-E-R. Campsite's alright. I think I prefer city camp. I think I've already said this in this video. But I prefer city camp. But Gaspere's cool. Or Gaspar. I took this path because I thought it would be more exciting. It's just more mudlogged. Mudlogged? More swampy. Water ridden. Damp, I don't know. Well, look, I've just come from there. That was my alternate path. I could have come that way, but I came this way because I love adventure, you know me. And yeah, now we're over here, and now I've just got to do a little walk down to here, I think, and I'll be back at the campsite, but we shall see. Also, this looks suspiciously beach like More footage of the same lake I've been showing you, but from a slightly different angle. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, man. Okay, so the area I need to be in is here, but unfortunately this bridge has collapsed and is taped off. And even if I was some sort of mad parkour expert, I don't think I could navigate this, or want to, through risk of hurting myself. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to backtrack, I'm going to find this path, and then I'm going to head that way, and then that way, back to the campsite. So, here we go again. I'm back, I got the kettle boiling, and
yeah, I think that's going to be it for today's video. I say today's there, sort of every other 3 days, every 3 or 4 days now. But yeah, I got the kettle on. I've had a lovely walk. That was awesome. I got to see a lot. That was really cool. But I'm very tired at the moment. We can do a brief overview tomorrow or something. But yeah. Okay, so I'm on my way to Groningen. I've just pulled over at the side of the road to get something to eat. I got myself a sausage roll from a Wild Bean Cafe and a Fanta. And over there, as you can see, we're doing pretty well. This is where we've stopped for the time being. I've made it to Groningen. I'm very happy that I'm here. It's much more relaxed than Stadspark. Check this place out. The reception's straight over there, so I've got good access to the Wi-Fi. But I'm in quite a secluded little area over here, which is nice. I've got power down there. There's like a forest all around me, which is cool. But if we go over here, I don't really want to get too many people's camper vans on camera. But look at this. Yeah, check this out, man. Oh well, we're going to have to go explore this, aren't we? I'll do a explore Groningen video later. That'll probably be another one, but yeah. Oh my god, it's so peaceful here. Yeah, today I'm on an adventure to find a place that sells cigarettes, and in order to do that I have to go down this way to Pavilion Lan, which is a very straight, very long road into Groningen from the campsite. So here we go. We've got to go down here. This little area at the start here is like a warm-up for this area all the way down here. But that, it just goes on forever and ever and ever and ever, and then you reach Groningen.
So alright, I think I'm about a third of the way down now, possibly.
So because most of Holland is built on reclaimed land, obviously there's a lot of waterways and everything going through the towns and cities. And it seems the further out we get to places like Groningen and Den Helder and places like that, the more the bridges get used. Whereas in Amsterdam, I think they've either stopped ships like this coming through the town centre, or all the bridges are high enough. Like they've got it right in Amsterdam. Out here I think, I don't know. This is Groningen Central Station, and it struck me when I saw it yesterday how similar it is to the Amsterdam one. I don't think I got any footage of the one from Rotterdam, but if you look at the station from Rotterdam, it's like brand new. It's like a brand new building almost. It's ridiculous. But I think that's because, I was talking to a Dutch student yesterday, and it's because Rotterdam was bombed to shit during the war. So all of their buildings are sort of like a mix between old and new, where they've rebuilt it all.
Alright, we're right here in the town centre, so I'm not too keen on talking because there's so many people about. But this is basically Groningen town centre as far as I can tell. And it's massive.
Round 2. Fight. You win. Flawless victory.
This is basically where my campsite is. If it wasn't for this fence and the bridge, you probably wouldn't even see it. And then this is what it looks like from the entrance. If we go over there, look, you can see the super bus, look. Let me see if I can zoom in. Da, 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 da. Super bus. Oh, come on, focus up. I know I haven't seen barely any of it. So there's an area for camper vans over there. That's the services, like all the bathroom and everything. That's one of the little chickens, I think, roaming around. Yeah, that's like the bathroom and the laundry and all that sort of stuff, showers. There's like a play area at the front there. I don't really want to just go walking around here filming people's camper vans, so I'm gonna assume that it goes up there and works its way all the way back round. And then from here, you can just go straight back over to the super bus. And then we're back at the super bus. So there you go. We're going to see about repairing this table before I go to Sweden tomorrow. So there's the broken leg.
And I think if I move it in slightly, or move it out slightly, depending on how it is in line with this other one, I think I'll just be able to screw it back in. Right, well, there you go. One repaired table that I found in a skip, and it hasn't cost me anything. So there you go. Excellent. The top's a bit rough, as you can probably see, and it's splitting a bit, but the legs are great. So what I can do, if I really want, is I can just cut a new top out of like some laminated plyboard or whatever, and I'll be sweet. So yeah, there you go, fix the table. Okay, so this morning I'm going to be leaving Groningen and starting my journey up to Sweden. It's going to take about 10 hours, I think. And you may be wondering where all my stuff is. I have moved it into here, so for the journey it isn't all knocking about and falling over the place and things like that. So yeah.
Okay, here we are in Denmark. Sorry, I didn't get any footage in Germany. It was a bit of a stressful one in Germany. The sat-nav kept taking me back. I went back to the same sort of industrial estate shopping area three fucking times because of this thing, man. I appreciate the use of the sat-nav. However, it got me lost because in Germany there are some new roads and the sat-nav didn't realise that the new roads were there, so it just kept turning me around. And so like, you've got to go back, and at one point it was like, you need to turn around on the motorway. No, absolutely not. So that's that
problem.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have my lunch, my turkey roll lunch. Let me see if I can undo this with one hand. Hang on. Hey, turkey! So yeah, you can see me eating as well. I'm a bit annoyed. I didn't want to get lost. This is probably all we're going to see of Denmark, sadly. Right, well, probably all you're going to see of Denmark. I've got to keep going up and down the very long road. And I keep feeling really funny, like, I know I'm not tired, but the long roads are kind of so boring they put you into a frame of mind where you could sort of just, you know, I don't know. It's not tired, but it is a bit daydreamy. I don't know what the best way to describe it is.
I'm going to eat my turkey rolls. The turkey was on offer. It was very good. Dutch turkey. I don't know if it's Dutch turkey, but it was certainly bought in the
land of the Dutch, in the Holland, in the Netherlands.
We made it to Sweden. Yeah, look. There's my chosen family, Kay and Kyle. And yeah, we're just walking around the lake at the minute on our way to town, I think.
This is a pond in Sweden.
Yeah.
What a massive lake that we know it as in England.
This is a pond to the lovely Swedish people. Oh wow, this is cool. That's mad. So this is the central station for Gothenburg. And then over there's the city proper. And then they got a tram system as well. So that's kind of cool. So we're going to be using the trams to go check out the museums. And so yeah. Sweden's nice. I like it here. It's kind of chilled and relaxing. It's cool. We're at the Universium. And apparently they've got an aquarium and some sciencey things.
And a rainforest
all under one roof. So that's going to be really cool to see. And also there's a Ferris wheel at the background there, which is also nice. Do pay attention, 007. This is the aquarium. We're about like four or five stories four or five stories up at the moment. And there's just ducks. And over here there are fish. This is trout and salmon. They seem to be in some kind of like stasis though. Like, they're all bunched up in this one corner and not really moving anywhere. So, it makes me feel a bit sad, like they need a bit more room to get around.
Managed to get one into the bank though. That's where capital comes from.
That's nice, man.
Manta ray.
Hello.
To the shark tunnel, open to the door to the rainforest.
He was like, look at me. Manta rays are boring. Look at me instead.
No, I want to look at the manta ray. That's crazy. He's got the world's largest fangs.
You can tell it's a viper. See the arrowhead-shaped head?
Yeah.
That's because those big bones, those big cheekbones, contain the gargantuan fangs.
And all the venom as well, I imagine.
Yeah. That's the most venom of all snakes.
I think we're in the rainforest area now. And it's really warm. It is ridiculously warm in here. This place is so cool. Look at the turtle go! Oh sweet, there's the turtle, tortoise, and then up the top there you've got more monkeys. This crocodile alligator thing, I can never tell the difference. We've found the space section here at the, I can never remember the name, Universium. I just want to call it the museum, but it's not. And they've got all sorts of crazy stuff here. Like, there's a space sleeping, there's an astronaut sleeping bag over there that I haven't tried out yet. This thing is all information about the ISS and things like that, which is also very, very cool. Okay, so we're at the next day now. I apologise if there's any wind, but check out this amazing view down here. Isn't that just the most perfect thing you've ever seen? And that's a... Is that a pond? That's the lake. Okay, this is the lake. And then there's another one that's sort of like a similar size that they just call the pond. And I think we could just go fishing down there. I might do some fishing later. Set the tripod up and get some video footage of me fishing. That'd be cool. Just got on the Paddan sightseeing boat. It goes under 20 bridges in Gothenburg and takes about 50 minutes.
So here on your right we have the Gothenburg City Museum. This was built to be the home office of the East India Trading Company, who sailed all the way down to China and brought back tea and silk, among other things. The East India Trading Company is considered to be one of Sweden's most successful companies throughout the time. So here on your right we have some old warships. They are all part of the Maritima Museum, which is one of the largest floating museums of the world. And among other things, you can visit a submarine in here.
Oh my god, I've got to go do that then, haven't I? I've got to. This entire structure sinks. That's crazy. Man, Swedish people are awesome. They got the engineering down. This is the lowest bridge in Sweden. Called the hairdresser's bridge, because if you don't lean down while going under it you'll get a new haircut when you come out the other side. Oh man, this is actually crazy.
He's going really slow on
purpose. Man, that's proper low, isn't it?
And then this one's a bit better. Okay. That's crazy. I didn't think they'd be allowed to drive under a bridge that low.
Moose, elk and hajort.
We've just got off the bus, or the boat, sorry, I keep getting that confused. We've just got off the boat, and I also, before I continue this video, I apologise for all the focusing problems. I fixed the focus on one video, and then I turn the camera off and it forgets all my settings, so that's no good. But we're in Sweden, we're about to try some moose. We're going to try and eat some moose. So, yeah, we'll see how this goes. I'll let you know. It should be a fun, exciting experience.
New food! Right,
so this is elk. I'm about to enjoy eating. Who got the wild boar?
Kyle
got the wild boar.
Okay, so the deer was delicious. Tasted a bit like kebab. But now we are here in the... Is this City Museum Gothenburg? And we're about to walk through the prehistoric area. Okay, so this is a bit of a odd one. The Rolfsakar man. He died 4,500 years ago. And he's been preserved in like the lime and that. It's a bit weird seeing a skeleton body, I don't know. Very strange. One thing I will remark though is that his teeth are in better condition than mine. So yes, that is one thing to consider. And apparently he received an axe wound to the leg. Let me just check this before he died. Yeah, he received a cutting blow to the leg before he died. This is very surreal. That's awesome, man. Oh, penannular brooches. They're for cloaks and stuff. That's cool. I learnt that because of Lindy Beige. If you want to know more about history and stuff, check out Lindy Beige's channel. He is a legend. And if we go over here, I think some people are playing a game. Trading game. What are you up to?
No idea.
Oh yeah, you're learning the rules.
She's having the time of her life over here.
You definitely want to be filming there.
What are you doing there, Kay? You've moved on from your selfie stick. What you got now?
It's the next big thing.
She doesn't
want to
go on the cruise
anymore.
She wants to
stay in. Ooh. Battery ran out. Sorry about that, people. I've made it to Stenzo. I've stayed here the night already. EG should be meeting me soon. And this is all going to be one big long video because I haven't been able to sort it out yet, do you know what I mean? So it's all just getting loaded onto the camera and yeah, so I'm at Stenzo. It's quite nice here. The drive up here was horrible. I'm feeling really homesick and that, but let me just take a little tour out here. So we've got a service building over here. And then you've got the toilets over there. The reception is up there somewhere. Look who it is!
It's EG!
Yay!
Oh, man.
Oh, this is so weird.
EG is on top of the bus, inspecting the solar system. This is mad, man. Meeting up with your friends that you've only spoken to on the internet is just like the most perfect thing ever. I love it.
Fucking yeah.
Hmm.
It's a bit dirty up here.
Oh, yeah. I bet. It's alright, I never get the roof on camera.
Okay, so we've made it to another campsite. But unfortunately, they don't have Wi-Fi, so I still can't upload this video yet. So, it's going to be a really, really long one. And tomorrow, I'm going to be on the boat to Estonia. And I'm getting a bit nervous about that. I'm getting further and further away from home. I know Laura's going to look after me, and, you know, we're good friends and that, but I am still a bit nervous, so... Yeah, I'll probably get some video footage off the boat tomorrow. I'm on the boat. I've made it onto the ferry. So we're about to leave Sweden and head to Estonia. I'm a bit relieved, actually. This was the most worrying part of the whole trip, and I've managed to pull it off. So, yeah. The docks were all under construction, so it was a nightmare getting around them. I didn't know where to go, but
I'm on the boat and I'm ready to get to Estonia and just, you know, relax.
Well, here we are. We made it. We are in Estonia, safe and sound with law. And yeah, we're about to hit the country. I'm just doing this video quickly so I can wrap this video up. And then once we get to the country, we'll do a sort of, I guess, a combo video and really explain what's going on. I might even get some fishing done. I think Lord's going to make some jam and things like that. So it's going to be a bit of an adventure. That's going to be cool. But we've made it. This is the house we're staying at the second. And then we're going to take this beast and drive it to the country. And yeah, so...
Hey there guys, welcome back to another episode of the Super Bus Tour with myself, KnuxVeeone, and Law! And yeah, we've made it to the country retreat. Little kitten was trying to climb in the van. This is Yoko. I think she's going to be a companion while we're here.
Probably. Neighbours.
The neighbour's cat. And just look at this place, it's amazing. I'll take you on a tour in a bit and we can have a look around. But first, we have food to sort out. Put in the fridge so it doesn't go off. And
yeah, as your doodad manager, I'm gonna say, let's sort out some food.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Onward.
Okay, so I've just got up. The van was very cold this morning and I'm sort of reluctant to get out of it when it's that cold because my duvet is so comfortable and warm. So I waited for it to heat up a little bit and then I got out of bed. So I had a bit of a lay-in this morning, but it was very cold. So now I am gonna hope that my lighter works in lighting this so I can have a cup of tea. The tea is on. Success. And I visited the outhouse, so we're all good. Just gonna wait for my tea and then I've got to find my wash bag so I can brush my teeth, but we're all good. Tea is on. Tea!
This is the view from our workplace. How amazing is that?
A little river down there, some trees. Very peaceful.
Okay, so Seeker Chapter 4 has undergone its first proper edit. So it just needs proofreading now. But we're going to do that all in one batch. So to relax, after all our good work, this bamboo cane is about to become a fishing rod. Now, ta-da! Bush Engineer Law has managed to successfully build a super fishing rod. This is just a test one. We're going to see what this is like, and then we might have to find a bigger rod.
It's only a model.
Yeah, it's the model. And yeah, so we're going to try this out. We've got some rye bread on the end, and we're going to try and use that as bait. We'll see what happens, but we'll let you know if we catch anything. Didn't catch any fish today, but dinner is on. And look at how delicious this looks. Got some beans. Got some cheesy toast. Some ham. And we're going to enjoy it. It's going to be delicious. It is time to collect the waterings. I've got my own bucket as well. I'm helping. Relocate base of operations, check. Enjoy milkshake and delicious pretzel treat, check. After this, oh, and we've also got the fire on to make jam. These blueberries are delicious. We're jamming. And we hope you like jamming too. Yeah, yeah.
We're jamming.
Jam, bitches. Ooh yeah, yummy yummy jam. Or in the process of making jam. Lord's just gone to run and grab a laptop because my hard drive has crashed. So yeah, I'm in charge of this. And if she returns and the house hasn't burnt down, then it'll be a miracle. And you've just done all the jars, eh?
Yep.
So they're all ready to go.
Sweet!
It works! I caught a little fishy!
This is probably going to go to the neighbour's cat, more than likely, but it proves that the system works, and now we can move on to a bigger system to catch bigger fish. So, yeah. There you go, a little bamboo rod that me and Law put together yesterday, and yeah. I'm going to eat you little fishy! And continuing with the theme of success, Law has successfully made jam. It's all safely wrapped up under here.
Okay. It's time for fishing rod mark 2. Okay, so if you avoid my shadow, this is the Super Rod Mark 2. It's got eye hooks so the thing can run through it. And I've also got this Y-shaped branch that I can rest it on, and I am allowed to use this as long as I don't use any lures with it, so that's cool.
Please excuse me, I have started a video and I am blowing a bug off my arm. Law has made the unfortunate mistake of letting me choose the directions, and yeah, so we're gonna meander around here and stick to the river a little bit, but yeah, poor choice, Law, letting me choose all the directions. We had a choice of hiking path or river, and I chose the route with the down tree in the way, so go figure. These are all the berries we've collected so far, and they are delicious, and we're going to keep picking, and there's a blueberry patch further in, so we'll be going there in a bit as well. Okay, so we've started on blueberries and foxberries. I'm on blueberry duty, Laura's on foxberry duty, and I have just found this gold mine. Look at this! Look at this! Very nice! A bountiful harvest of raspberries, blueberries and foxberries. And Law's just finishing up the foxberries there, second container full. Now this is the sort of thing that is worthy of Instagram. Not your damn cheese and ham toasties and all that nonsense. Look, picked berries and sexy ice cream. I've also got my washing to do. We're going to hook up a temporary washing line for this, because the current washing line I don't think is going to be big enough, and also I've got so many clothes that it'd just be easier to set up a really long line and do it that way. There has been something of a disaster at Chaos Nova
temporary headquarters.
The dongle that we're using has been exposed to liquid. Internet technician Law has successfully repaired the device. What a legend. Where are we going, Law?
We're going potato hunting.
Ooh! Do you know a good potato hunting ground?
I might.
Ooh, exciting!
They say it's quite beside the super bus.
Ooh. What, this super bus?
Oh, yeah, oh. So I've heard.
Ooh! Oh wow, this is quite the potato patch. Ta-da! That's amazing.
Are there any more? Oh, two more. Of course I didn't take a box with me. Yeah, I think this is...
Potato!
Shouldn't you say potato?
Potato!
Potato, potato.
Ooh!
Big ones.
Nice. Okay, this is what remains of the perch that Law's dad caught, I think it was a couple of days ago, maybe? I could be wrong there, possibly last week. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to debone it, and I'm going to take all the scales and everything off, like these... not scales, fins, and I might mash it all in this bowl and add some mayonnaise. That's my tuna. We're going to have baked potatoes. So, yes. Potatoes. A great success. Very nice. Let me just put the camera down here, and I hope you can see what's going on. And if all has gone to plan, save that bag for later, I open this box and these should be dry by now and ready to eat. Ta-da! Don't they look delicious? So all that literally is melted chocolate and cornflakes, and now we've got ourselves some nice cakes to enjoy. And you can see Laura over there cooking food. And you can see Laura's dad over there cooking wood. And yeah, I think we're having carrots, potatoes and sausages for dinner tonight. And there's also some birch tree sap available for drinking. I keep tripping over the same log. Yeah. This is birch tree sap, and it'll be my pleasure to try some of that later tonight. Laura's got a look on her face as if to say no. But yeah, okay. Potatoes, freshly dug up from the ground, the earth has provided, and then some carrots, and then some sausages. Yeah!
Dinner is served.
Yummy. This takes you out to the little pier, and yes, there's my fishing rod. Still haven't tested it yet. Will do eventually, or I might just take it back to the UK with me and see what it's like there. I need to find the right time to do it, you know. I'm a bit busy and a bit worried about getting to the next dock on time. I don't have to worry until the 14th is my worry date, official worry date. For getting to the next port, which will take me to Germany, and I don't have to be at the port until the 18th, but or the 17th. I need to go check that. But yeah, I'm not worrying about it until the 14th, so that can wait. But yeah, this is where we've been staying for the past couple of months. I think it's been about a couple of months. And it's going to be amazing to see my family and friends again. I really do miss them. Every time I call the UK, everyone's either working or they don't answer the phone and things like that, which is fair enough. They've all got lives to lead. But it would just be nice to speak to someone, you know. I'm sure I'm driving Law crazy with my constant sort of questions. Like, oh, can I have a cup? Oh, have you got a knife? Oh, are we cooking dinner? Oh, are we doing this? Oh, are we doing that? So I'm sure she's... I don't know, but I wouldn't like to be in her position with me constantly asking questions. So, there you go. So when I get back to the UK, she can get some peace and quiet and won't have to look after the crazy English dude who sort of just invaded the place. But there you go.
Dinner is served.
And today we are preparing... preparedness to leave the countryside for the final time, and we're going back to town. We're gonna resupply for my drive through Latvia to the dock that's gonna take me to Germany. So we're heading back into town now. I think we're gonna get some washing done and restock via shopping. I'm gonna get some diesel. I was about to say petrol then. I'm gonna get some diesel. And yeah, so that'll be that. But yeah, I'll be driving through Latvia. I haven't got any sat-nav data for Latvia, so what I've done is I've downloaded a Google GPS type thing. Copilot, I think it's called. But obviously that's going to take bandwidth, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn it on every now and then to make sure I'm heading in the right direction and not going to get lost in everything. I'm also going to buy a compass today as well, just to make sure that I don't ever head east from where I am now, because that would be a fucking disaster. So here we are back in town. But unfortunately, today is the day that I gotta leave. Here's the super bus. Laura's just enjoying her morning coffee. And yeah, in about half an hour, I'm gonna be heading off to Latvia. And then from Latvia, I'll be getting on the ferry to Germany. That'll be tomorrow. Tomorrow morning, I should be on the ferry to Germany. But yeah, I've had a great time in Estonia. And we got some work done, and I got to experience the outdoors in ways that I've never done before. So there you go. Right, so here we are. Give a wave. We're on the main road that's going to take me pretty much all the way to Latvia. Oh, look, some cam reception. And
Oh yeah, E264. Uh-huh. Yeah, that's the one I got to take, and I'm going to be on this road for about 5 hours now. And yeah, so it's been a pleasure, Law. Thank you very much for having me. And I look forward to our next engagement. But yeah, the super bus is on its way now, and that's it from Estonia, I think. Oh, that's sad, man. I'm gonna miss her. This was awesome hanging out in Estonia. Fantastic. I did some work for her dad, like helping the family clear the forest and things like that. But right, before we go, this is my notepad. I'm gonna cover this up because this is someone's address. This is where I've got to go, and that's also my reference number, but unless you're about to board the same ferry as I am, after seeing this video, it's not going to make much difference. So this is all my stuff to get onto the Stena line. The sat-nav has no navigation data, I'm just using it for the compass, and if that compass fails, Law has given me this one, which is a rather fancy compass, and that's going to hopefully... Look at this bad boy! Yeah, that's badass. I'm still not 100% on how to use it, but I think I've got a good idea. Like, this is always going to point north, so as long as I'm going in the opposite direction, I want to be going southwest. If I go east, I'll end up in Russia, and I don't want to end up in Russia. Okay, so here we are, driving through Latvia, or we've stopped at the minute, because there's roadworks going on up ahead, and I've got to let the oncoming traffic come through first, and then we're going to go after that. I've been here for about 2-3 minutes already, possibly even longer, and I haven't seen a single car go past me in this direction, so there you go. But yeah, I'm not too fond of driving through Latvia. If I had sat-nav data, I'd probably do a better job of it, but still, I don't know. But I'm focused on the fact that I'll be going home in under a week or so, or just over a week. Oh look, cars! Cars are coming. So yeah, I'm keeping that in my head. I'm gonna be home in just over a week, and also I'm seeing my other friends in Germany, so that'll be cool. I'm looking forward to that. The super bus has made it to the ferry port. Massive thanks to my dad for giving us the last little bit of information I needed. Pram due, that's passenger terminal, I think, in Latvian. And then I went over there and found the nice gentlemen who were protecting the border, and they told me that I was in the right place to jump on the ferry tomorrow. I'm going to try and find, I think this is the restaurant over here, so I'm going to go check this place out and see if I can get myself a cheeky little meal, and I think I should be able to see the van from there, which would be nice. I don't know how well you can see the sign there, but that says Zitari Krogs, and I highly recommend, that place is awesome. I had a burger and an apple juice, and nothing says manly man like sitting in a group of other people and ordering yourself an apple juice. I don't know, if I could say one thing about the super bus tour, it's that don't ever do it alone, because as soon as you leave the people that you're familiar with, like I've left Law today, and she's called to go back to her family and all that sort of stuff, like she's got people there, and it was the same with when I met Kaylee and Kyle in Sweden. They were cool because they were going straight home after hanging out with friends and relatives in Sweden. And then when I met EG again, he was going back home to his folks, so that was all cool for him. But I get left on my own, you know, and I miss my parents, I miss my friends, I miss my family. And yeah, I don't know, I'm just lonely. So if I could say one thing about the Superbus tour is that if you're going to do this, if you're going to follow in my footsteps and build yourself a bus and all that nonsense, learn from my mistakes first of all, don't build a bed that can slide out, build one at the back of the van that you can, you know, you don't have to pull out every time you want to go to sleep properly and things like that. And second of all, get a companion, get someone to come with you, because you're going to be on your tod. Hello! I made it to Germany! Yes! Victory is mine!
I'm sorry that there was no footage on the boat from Latvia, but I have safely arrived and I am enjoying the fine company of Nadia and Tony. I'm loving it, it's excellent here, and we're just going on a little walk through the forest, exploring the place, having a peaceful evening, and yeah. Walking through the forest, we've just found this graveyard, and it looks very cool here. We're gonna sneak in here, look.
Let's sneak in. And this, it belonged to lords and people with titles and that sort of thing. And they used to own a lot of land, and so they were able to put this graveyard here in the middle of the forest, which is really cool. It's quite peaceful here. It's getting a bit dark now, so I'm not sure if you can see this, but YouTube probably won't be helping any. But for some reason, I get a vibe of Hockley Woods off of this place, which is cool. It's awesome. I like it a lot. Again, I don't know how well you can see this, but we're about to climb the mountain of Bakam. And this mountain was made from the sort of leftovers from the coal mine. So they piled it all up and now it's the mountain. So I'll get you some pictures from the top. Here we go. How mad is that? Okay, so I've just left my Italian friends and I've been driving for about an hour now. It was an absolute pleasure to stay with them, and it was so awesome that people I met in Amsterdam and people that I met in Holland were so willing to put me up and treat me like they're just perfect hosts. I can't thank them enough. Thank you very much, guys. That's awesome. And you know you're always welcome in the UK. So in this direction is Germany, and if we go this way, in this direction is Holland. So I've just pulled over here, and I think is a truck stop. I don't even think I'm supposed to be here, but there are other people here, so we'll all get in trouble together. In 12 hours or so, I'm going to be back on home turf, and maybe even in bed. So yeah. Very strange to put an end to the trip. I don't know how I feel about it. It's going to be good to see my friends and family and everything, but at the same time, I don't know. Yeah, it would be nice to have a nice relax in my own bed, in my own home, do you know what I mean? But at the same time, I'm probably going to get home and start itching for adventure again, because I've had such a good time in Germany, and yeah. Oh, it's been awesome. I can't wait till I'm back out here again. It's going to be cool. Okay, I have made it to the Hook of Holland. I am 20 minutes away from checking in, and then after that I'll be getting on the boat with the rest of these troublemaking caravan people, and we'll be home, or we'll be on our way home. Thank you everyone who's had me, and thanks to all the campsites who have put up with me, thanks to all the people's houses I've crashed in, or saunas, or let me use land on their property to park up and sleep for the time being. Thank you very much. It's been an absolute pleasure, and you're all legendary. Hey, look, recognize this? This would be the same boat that brought us here to Europe. Right, brought us to the Hook of Holland, and now it's going to take us home. That's cool. Yeah, I don't really know what to say. I'm a bit sad to be leaving Europe, a bit sad to be leaving everyone behind. It doesn't quite hit you until you're on the boat and you're like, you're finally going home sort of thing, how sad it really is to say goodbye to everyone. But I'll be back soon enough. They can't get rid of me that easy. So, yeah. And next time, hopefully, I'll be bringing a friend with me so we can explore all this madness together. I was just chilling out in the smoker's lounge, and then an announcement came over the board that was like, cabins for 22 euros. So guess where I am? In my own cabin, bunk beds, towels, places to charge my laptop and things like that. And if we go in here, there's even a bathroom. How cool is this? So I've got a shower, I've got a sink, toilet, got a big old mirror. Look at that ugly mug. Hello. So yeah, oh, how cool is this? Sadly, I think my time in the cabin is coming to an end. I think we're about an hour away from pulling into port, but you've got to log out of the cabin before you pull into dock, basically, so they can get it all sorted out and know what's what. If you can get a cabin for cheap, definitely do it, because it's just nice to have your own space and somewhere to chill out and have a bathroom, and you don't have to worry about nothing. It's all good. I hope you can hear me over the wind, but here we go. We're back in Harwich. We're back home, back in the UK. Oh, it's such a weird feeling. I feel so sad for leaving all my friends behind. Oh. You know, it feels like the end of a really good book. So, yeah, it's a shame. I'm a little bit sad, but we're home now. All the comforts are home. And I can always do this again. I think I need to get the van looked at though, because it was a bit sluggish on the way here from Germany. So yeah, I might have to get that looked into, but we're here, we're home, we've made it back to Harwich. And very beautiful it is too, in an industrial kind of way. Yeah. Well, back in the UK. What an adventure it's been. Hopefully all my friends will come and visit me now. Hopefully they'll come and get a flight out to the UK. Obviously I'm not expecting all of them to build super buses and follow me, but that would be cool. But a flight out here will do. Anybody who's helped me in Europe, you've got a place in the UK for life. So yeah, I look forward to seeing you all. Come visit. Well, the super bus made it back home last night around, I think it was about 9 o'clock-ish. Managed to get the super bus all the way home from Harwich, and it didn't take as long as I thought it was going to take, but I'm just glad to be home now. It's all good. So yeah, that's the end of the super bus adventure. This is what I'm having for breakfast this morning: a Krispy Kreme's donut and a cup of tea. So there you go. But yeah, I'm all set back up in here and ready to do my YouTube and all that nonsense, so let's do it, let's crack on. Thank you so much for joining me for the Superbus tour. It's been an absolute pleasure, and I'm glad you've enjoyed the videos, and yeah, I will catch you on the next one. Take it easy, all the best, thanks for watching, bye bye.
So there you have it, finally the Superbus project was a complete success. I managed to get all the way from the UK to Estonia and back again. Several ferries, lots of campsites, lots of places to stay. You could look back at the Mark 1 Superbus and the Mark 2 Superbus and think they were failures. And in a way, you're kind of right, but they're failures that taught me something. And the fact that I didn't give up, I chose not to give up with the Superbus Mark 3, like, I kept going. And I wasn't willing to accept failure for the third time. I wasn't even really prepared to accept failure the second time. But I kept going, and eventually it worked out, and I had an amazing time touring Europe. I'm looking forward to many more tours of Europe. The next adventure's already planned. I don't know when it's going to happen, but I'm going to the south of Italy with my lovely Italian friends who put me up in Germany for a week or so. So I'm looking forward to that. It's going to be good. Yeah, so I hope you've enjoyed this documentary. It went on for a bit longer than I thought it was going to go on for, but I wanted to make a detailed version of the story from the Superbus Mark 1 all the way to what we accomplished with it, so that if anyone else is thinking of doing this sort of stuff, or if anyone else is interested and just needs that little push, then maybe this will be that push. I didn't succeed in the first two vehicles that I put together, but I learnt an awful lot, and that's the important thing. Life's all about experiences, do you know what I mean? And this was the experience of a lifetime, and because it's a vehicle that I can now take wherever I want, it doesn't have to stop, I can keep going. So yeah, thank you so much for joining me for this, and I really appreciate all the support everyone's shown over the years for the Superbus project, all the help people have given. And that's going to be all from me. Thanks very much. Take it easy.